Hello, Damon Mercy Solutions. Today we're going to look at Quickpar and how we can use Parity and Par2 files to protect data, and how this could be used with very little space overhead to archive data and add that extra level of redundancy if you had any problems with the media reading the file back in the future. And also it can be used to ensure that you've got all the files back in their original form without any data loss. Let's jump into it. Okay, so what I want to take a look at today is how we can use erasure encoding to create a form of redundancy on media which we're archiving files, and how we can use this to protect files from data loss. Now, if you're writing files to a hard disk, tape, or even optical media, you can have problems with that media potentially reading it back in the future, and data can actually be lost. I've actually got here a hard disk platter. If I bring this up, you can see the circles on the disk there. This is where actually the head of the hard disk is actually crashed into the media, and you can see it's actually taken away the actual data, physically stripped it from the actual platter, which is 100% data loss. You're not going to get that data back. Now, if that had been your hard disk that you'd been archiving data on the shelf, perhaps you dropped it as you pulled it back, there's a good chance the head's going to crash and you're going to get that sort of problem. So what we're going to do, I'll just jump straight in here. I've got a folder of pictures, and we can use a software called Quickpar on Windows and to create a Parity archive. Let me open up the software. So I've got Quickpar here, and I can literally add the files, and what I will do is just drag all of these files into there. So Control A, drop them in, and we can just take the default options here, and we can actually say that I want to use 10% redundancy, and we'll tell it to create. And you can see this is real time, so there's 25 megs in there, and it's created the redundancy. I can now run a quick verification, and we can see now we've got 8 recovery blocks and all of the files here. So let me close Quickpar, and we'll come back to the folder. So you can see within my folder now, I've now actually got these PAR files. So I've actually got 4 files and the index file for the Parity. So what we can now do to archive these files, we can write all of these to the media, whatever our choice is. But if we have any problems, say for instance, this file here, or let's choose a different one. This one, literally I've just deleted that file. I can now open this up, Quickpar. And so now opening Quickpar, we can see that this file here is missing. But I have the option here to press repair. If I press repair, what you can see is the Parity information has been used to actually reconstruct this file and replace it. So losing the complete file is probably less of a case that's likely to happen. If I was to open this up with actually Notepad++, and let me bring this over here. Let me go in and actually, let's just select a few lines of the data, and let's just delete it. And we'll close that one, and we'll save it. Yep. And let's just do a couple more files. Let's open this one as well. And let's just select some more, and we'll delete some more data, and we'll save this as well. Okay, so I've physically gone and corrupted a couple of files here now, and I will open up the PAR files again. Just bring this back onto the system, so we can see this file is incomplete. And so is this one. So we can see there's a problem with the pair of them. And again, I can use the PAR files information to repair these files. And by running the repair again, those files are now being put back to original. So you can see by creating these Parity files, you've actually got the ability to protect your data as you're storing it. And it protects against failures of the media. So where do you get Quickpar to? So bring up a web browser. So Quickpar for Windows can be downloaded from quickpar.org.uk, and go onto the website here and can just download from here. This is open source software, or rather it's free software, supported by donations. On Macs, there's MacPAR deLuxe. This can also be downloaded from the website here, used on a Mac. And on the Linux, there's the command line par2 that can be used to read and write these files. So you can see with archiving, by creating par2 files, you're not only protecting the data, but you're also allowing that protection to be used across multiple platforms. It's not just tied to a Windows machine. Thank you for watching to the end of the video. If you found this useful, please press the like button, as this will let other people find the video. You should have a suggested video to the right here, which YouTube thinks is most appropriate, but also consider subscribing to the channel, and you'll then get in your feed and notifications of new videos when they're released. We aim to release a video every Thursday, and most weeks we achieve this. Thank you.